I like to give you a short overview about my work and the work from my best friend from Canada, Dr. Brian Wells, who cannot come to this conference. So, during my overview, I like to present you something like a roadmap how to analyze Indus writing. So, this roadmap based on previous decipherments of other ancient writing systems like the Egypt hieroglyphs, cuneiform writing, Maya hieroglyphic writing, and my own experiences working on the decipherment of Hephaestus and the Cretan hieroglyphic writing. So the first step in analyzing a writing system is to collect all available inscriptions, putting them together into a corpus of inscriptions. So this was the main task for the last 40 years, mostly by Dr. Brian Wells. And so there is this interactive corpus of inscriptions of Indus texts available online, and I welcome everybody who is interested in this contacting me to access this database, which is online and free accessible. There are about 3,350 inscribed artifacts stored in the database and containing about 5,300 texts at present. So one of the first steps when you have collected all the texts is to define a sign list. So you need not only define a sign list, but you also need to analyze the signs. If they are similar, do they actually are different signs or the same sign with the same meaning? So there are different mathematics I have presented here during this conference, and so one of them is the statistical analysis for the segmentation of inscriptions. And it allows you to see pattern of inscriptions. This is how the sign are used in the initial or in the terminal position of texts. As you may know, mainly the texts are need to be read from right to left. So this allows us to define a sign list, and based on this sign list, you can go further on with the interpretation of certain sign classes. There have been several signs already analyzed by other scholars, including Brian Wells. So there are numerical signs, fish signs, initial cluster signs, terminal markers, and I just go through this. And here, this is one of the weakest, most frequent signs used as a grammatical marker at the end of inscriptions, but also as a solo text, as you can see on the top left corner, used as one text, the sign itself. Probably used in this context as a logogram. Based on the analysis of fish signs, this is a table which summarizes the work from Dr. Brian Wells. He analyzed the different graphic variations of fish signs and how they are correlated to the weight system of the Indus culture. So he's proposing the association of certain signs to specific weights of the Indus culture, as you can see in this table. This is one of the reasonings why this specific order of fish signs should occur in specific order. Another class of signs analyzed are numerals. Most of them are just strokes, so different number of strokes representing different numbers. But what kind of numerical value they have it was one of the big questions I was facing. So there are, first of all, different types of strokes, long strokes from 1 to 9, maybe indicating a base 10 decimal system, short strokes from 1 to 7, maybe indicating a base 8 or octal system, short stack strokes, and specific special numbers, signs on the bottom with unknown value. So when I'm analyzing Indus writing, I discovered several sets of inscriptions representing what I like to call numerical equations. So some kind of reference between the number represented in the text and the content. Either it is the number of reconstructed bangles in the pot, or it is given as a number because it's the sum of two other numbers on the same text. In a third case, in the bottom, you can see counting two different things, how they are correlated. So the numerical expressions in these tablets and seals are indicating that specific sign pairs represent a specific item with a weight of, in one case, approximately 10.6 grams. Another sign just used by itself represents most likely an item of about 4.12 grams. So putting all the things together is summarized in this overview table, that we are facing two different numerical systems in the Indus writing. One is the decimal system, base 10, represented by long strokes, and occasionally also a sign which looks like a bracket. And on the other side, we have also short strokes representing an octal system, base 8. Additionally, we have also the weight system, which conforms to the counting of items. And in some cases, we can also see the mixture of base 8 and base 10 systems using short strokes and long strokes in one inscription together. So these are some insights concerning special types of signs I have talked about. And so the next step in the analysis of Indus writing is to use this segmentation method to get more information about the syntax of writing. So which kind of word class is standing in the initial part, maybe a subject, then there is a weight information, in this case about 193 grams, then a logogram, numerical information, and at the end some kind of information about maybe a unit or the content of what is being counted, and at the very end a grammatical marker. So this example should illustrate that we can get more information when analyzing the structure. And the next step would be to analyze specific classes of words combined with grammatical markers in the initial cluster or in the terminal cluster. So word morphology is one of the next steps which needs to be done. And once you have done the work on the syntax and the morphology in the next future, you can define or maybe detect even the Indus writing language. This is one of the hopes, the aims of my further research I'm facing for the next years. So when it comes to this point, you may get a better idea about the, what the texts may represent, but how to verify certain interpretations. And then this is the point where the archaeological context comes in. And it's very important, I think, to analyze the artifact distribution in Mohenjo-Daro, in the structure of the houses and the blocks, how they are used in together with the seals and the inscriptions. So one of the main goals for the future will be to analyze the archaeological context and the inscriptions on the seals together to get an interpretation of content of these inscriptions. So you can add to this kind of analysis the sign function of logograms, grammatical markers, and this is maybe one of the major steps we are facing in getting a better understanding on what is actually written on the Indus seals. Thank you.